Welcome back. It's still Tuesday, June. Thank you. 2016. I'm still Yael Lavie with the morning edition i24 News. Ecstatic that Ami Kaufman is here to save me every single time. And I'm sporting a slight fever over the course of the several few days.
How high is it now?
I have no idea because I'm seeing a vision of this beautiful woman in red.
Wow.
I'm seeing this like red, beautiful woman in red, but she is trumped by the gorgeous man.
Speaking of fever.
Sitting next to her. He's going like this. You missed me. You missed me.
Kinda.
Okay. Kinda, a little bit. Maya Kramer-Shachal.
Yes.
And we have all gathered here for you today.
Yes, you have.
And you are dressed for the Oscars. Why?
The 69th annual Tony Awards.
We love the Tonys. Tony Sunday, and I. Yes. Sorry, Ami and I especially.
Yeah. I see. Ami is very dressed appropriately. Actually, you could have been my date.
the Tonys.
Now the Tonys. Yes, the Tonys. 18 hours following the tragedy in Orlando, they actually dedicated the ceremony to those affected. The most common accessory worn by performers and presenters were the silver ribbons, which was the color of the award itself, in memory of the victims.
Right.
In addition, the dress is being worn were a sure sign that life must go on and no one will stop Americans from being bold and fearless. In the past shows, we've seen a lot of black classic dresses, if you remember, like things that are a little more dull.
Of course I do, because I used to attend this every single year.
Right. Yeah. But the Tonys gave a whole other message. We'll start with the florals, okay?
Yeah.
So Lupita Nyong'o, who always dresses impeccable at every award show. I mean, she just always looks so beautiful. She never gets it wrong. Her style is flawless, and she proved it again in this Boss floral print off the shoulder dress, looking very feminine. And as you see, the florals also in the background. A lot of red
roses. I am. I'm speechless
stunning.
I'm speechless from that. Actually, looks a little bit like a. Yeah, like a mural? No, yeah, it's
and
gorgeous.
Yes, okay. And a there's a bitch stole my look moment. Sophie Okonedo took a few tips from Lupita and wore a very similar dress.
Mm.
Zac Posen floral off-the-shoulder dress.
Okay.
Who wore it better?
you weren't there, so nobody did.
Right.
Yes.
Pascal Armand went for a chiffon floral mix. So chiffon top, there's a bra under that, Ami, relax. with hints of intricate floral in the skirt of the dress. And we have fashion queen Anna Wintour, seen here with B. Schaffer, who both dress in gentle floral prints. Otherwise, she would not have been seen with her, of course, if she wasn't wearing that trend.
Exactly.
And the next we have a very beautiful threesome. Again, Ami, threesome floral print dresses, making florals look glamorous and perfect for the red carpet. So everyone looked beautiful in flowers.
It's Jane Krakowski, my favorite.
Yes, it is.
Exactly.
She's awesome. Black and white is always popular, right?
Right.
But here they took it to a whole other level. We have first floral prints meeting black and white. Let's have a look at Busy Phillips and Michelle Williams, who made a simple white dress into an evening look, although not such a great tone for her skin. It's hard to tell where the dress is and what her skin tone is. And next we see black and white done so right, from Cate Blanchett to Lia Kabedi. They've just all taken it to a whole other level. It's not boring, it's classic, it's beautiful, it's interesting. It's like a piece of art.
Yes.
Yes, but my fashion award goes to Ghana-born actress Akuzie Abuja for bringing some color into her black and white dress.
Okay, but we don't have it.
It's amazing, beautiful.
It was amazing.
My second award goes to Glenn Close. Glenn Close wore a, she's just 1 year short of her 70th birthday, and she wore a really low cut, there it is, with a very high slit, something my grandma probably would never wear.
Yeah.
You would never see her in that.
I don't know, it looks a little bit like a Christmas present, but
but still very ballsy for a 70-year-old woman. Another oldie but goodie, Jessica Lange, who really looked similar to Caitlyn Jenner from Glamour Woman of the Year Awards. So who is who? Where's Jessica Lange? But back to the most important part of the show, which was Lin-Manuel Miranda.
Yes.
His acceptance speech, which was very touching. One of the 11 awards won for Hamilton. He couldn't have rhymed it better. Let's have a look.
And I did. And he actually, just before we started that Hamilton, that I think, I don't know how many.
11.
11 out of the 16 nominations.
Breaks the record of 12, which was the producers.
Yes.
In 2000, I don't remember when.
You're amazing. But Lin-Manuel Miranda, man of the hour in so many ways over the course of the last, I think, year. And this was his acceptance speech on two days ago.
When senseless acts of tragedy remind us that nothing here is promised, not one day. The show is proof that history remembers. We live through times when hate and fear seem stronger. We rise and fall and light from dying embers, remembrances that hope and love last longer. And love is 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 love.